Mr. Chair, and thank you, Commissioner, for coming here and for starting the infringement procedures. I think that is most welcome, and we knew that it had been in the pipeline for quite some time. However, this House has been debating the problems with golden passports since 2014. Why did it take so long? Why did the authorities wait so long to intervene? Why did we have to wait for brave journalists to uncover the scandals that we all suspected for a long time? And some of these journalists have paid a very high price, the highest price, as we know. But journalists are not responsible for law enforcement. The authorities are, and the authorities are failing. Now, those who have a legitimate interest in investing in the European economy can do so without problem. And no golden passport nor a golden visa scheme can ever really be clean and legitimate, because due diligence that relies on cooperation with the Russian and the Chinese and the Saudi authorities, frankly, can never be watertight. And I'm being polite here. And despite the fancy names of the schemes, you know, residency by investment sounds nice, huh? Evokes these images of villas and yachts and what have you. In reality, they're just a golden backdoor into the European Union for criminals. Criminals. It's not investment, it's criminal money. Now, we need a full ban, and we're calling on the European Commission, not for the first time, to propose legislation. And I'm proud to say that at the initiative of my group, Renew Europe, the Libe Committee is going to draft a legislative initiative calling for a ban on golden passports. But of course, this is national competence. You know, national governments cannot sell what is not theirs to sell, and that is EU citizenship. It isn't theirs. They cannot sell it. So our governments, is the Council finally also going to take responsibility, or will they continue to knowingly facilitate criminals? And a final question, Commissioner, will you also address, let's say, the legacy, those who have already received a Cypriot or Maltese or other passport? Will there be a second screening to see what kind of people we have actually elevated to the status of EU citizen? Thank you.